हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द न्यू एकेडमिक सेशन 2020-21. लेट अस बिगिन आवर फर्स्ट डे विद अ ब्यूटीफुल कोट. वर्क हार्ड, ड्रीम बिग, नेवर गिव अप. सो आर यू रेडी टू वर्क हार्ड थ्रू आउट द ईयर? यू हैव लर्नड स्टडीड मेनी थिंग्स इन हिस्ट्री सिविक्स लास्ट ईयर. वी स्टडीड एंशियंट इंडियन हिस्ट्री लास्ट ईयर. Let us memorize what all you had learned. In the beginning, you learnt about the subcontinent of India. The complete map of India you have learnt. Then different dynasties prevailed in India. The period of Gupta, Mauryas, etc. But do you know on what basis we had learnt about it? Only on the basis of various sources in history. Do you remember some of them? Various monuments, worship places, stupas, structures, coins. We had learnt last year. Do you remember Ashoka Stambha, Pillar of Ashoka? So these were some examples of sources. This year, some more sources we are going to learn. After ancient Indian history in 6th standard, we are going to study medieval period in India in 7th standard. Medieval period means from 9th century till the end of 18th century. You all know, children, that we live in modern period. You have learnt about ancient period. And this year, we are going to learn about the medieval period. So tell me, how many years we need to go back to know this period? It is very simple. Children, now you are living in 21st century. You have entered in 21st century, isn't it? So 9th century means 900 CE and 18th century means 1800. Century means, you know, how many years? 100 years. So 1800 years, then 1900, then 2000, and now we have entered in 21st century. So medieval period started near about 1100 years ago and ended 320 years ago. Children, whatever we learn in history is only on the basis of sources. It is very important to evaluate the sources. Means, evidences, proofs must be authentic, true in every sense. There are four factors which are very, very important from the viewpoint of history. I have taught you last year. Do you remember those four major pillars or factors of history? Yes, ISPT. What do you mean by ISPT? Individual, society, place, and time. We cannot write history without these four factors. So let us classify these sources into material, written, and oral sources. In the beginning, let us see the examples of material sources. These are the material sources. Monuments, we'll see. These are the samadhis. Then let us move on to the graves. Graveyard. Have you heard about it? The dead person is buried over here. Graveyard. Then let us move on to the Virgala. These are the carvings of God and goddesses on stones. Then these are the ministerial mansions, the houses or the palaces of kings and queens. Even the houses of common people comes under the material sources. The next is written sources. and we will see the examples of written sources in our next video. Thank you, children.